Olaf Noor. This is Vishwanathan, working as assistant professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering from St. Martin's Engineering College. Today I am going to discuss about the LV switches. LV switches are low voltage or low tension circuit breakers. Now, in the first one is SFU. SFU is nothing but switch fuse unit. Switch fuse unit. This switch fuse unit is nothing but normal fuses whenever the load current, load current flows or any short circuit happens, this will be protected the circuit. Means this will break the circuit. What it will break the circuit means now actually fuse SFU, then for the SFU fuse, we will place a wire that is fuse wire. Whenever one flows, the fuse wire will be blown. Whenever the first blown, then the circuit will be break. Due to that, the entire circuit will be protected. But this was used in old days. But nowadays we are using MCBs. What is MCB? MCB is nothing but miniature circuit breaker. Miniature circuit breaker. These miniature circuit breakers will be used for the household purposes and for the office purposes. Those ready will be, MCB ready will be used from 16 amperes to 80 amperes. So next one is MCCB. MCCB is nothing but molded case. Molded case circuit breaker. These circuit breakers will be used from above 100 amperes, from 100 amperes to 1600 amperes. These molded case circuit breakers of MCCBs will be used for the industrial purposes. And next one is ELCB. ELCB is nothing but earth leakage. Earth leakage circuit breaker. Earth leakage circuit breaker. By seeing the name itself, you can know that the electrical circuit breaker will be used for the protecting the devices or protecting the loads from the electrical cages. Okay. And next one is RCCB. RCCB is nothing but residual current circuit breaker. Residual current circuit breaker. In the residual current circuit breaker, this will be operated by the currents. But by coming into the ELCB, this will be actually ELCB consists of two types. One is voltage operated one, another one is current operated one. But mostly we will use the RCCB, that is current operated one. This RCCB will also comes under ELCB only. This RCCB will be very much used as compared to the voltage operated ELCB. And let us see in detail that MCB. What is MCB? MCB and MCCB both construction wise both are same. MCB and MCCB construction wise both are same. But this MCB will be used from 16 amperes to 18 amperes range, and MCCB will be used from 100 amperes to 1600 amperes range. Now let us see. I have already drawn a diagram for the MCB, and this is the line. This line which is coming from the supply side, and this is the load. The load which is connected to the load. See, whenever the current supply from the supply, the current will enter into this. Means the MCB consists of two terminals. One is connected to the supply side, another one is connected to the load side. Okay, and neutral one is directly connected. And the whenever the supply current given, the current will be flows from supply, and it will enter. If this switch was closed in the normal condition, then whenever the switch is closed, the current will flows from like this, and again it will goes to here, and it flows into the solenoid. Whenever the current flows into the solenoid, then the solenoid will not be fully magnetized. It will be magnetized even though it is not fully magnetized. But the current is flowing like this, up to the bimetal strip, and after that it will comes toward the flow. But in this case, this is a normal operating condition. In this normal operating condition, it will be like this. So this will be closed. But whenever the fault condition means, that one first fault condition is overload. Overload condition, and second one is short circuit condition. Short circuit condition. In the overload condition, what will happen? For example, in the normal operating trying to pull this or attract this. Okay, but the current which is flowing through this bimodal strip also. What is the function of bimodal strip? For example, if I am taking one copper material, whenever you are heating up this by place of temperature, then it will bend like this. And if I am taking two different materials like aluminium, another one, whenever we are applying some temperature to this or some we are heating this, then it will also bend. But whenever we are combining, we are taking these two. Whenever we are taking combining these two, that is copper and aluminium, for example, I am taking here. Whenever we are heating up this, then it will bend any one of the directions. Like this, here also, whenever the overcurrent flows, we know that current is proportional to the temperature. If the temperature is proportional to the current. Like this. So, whenever the overflow current is flowing through this wire and through this bimodal strip, then what will happen? Obviously, the whenever the overflow current flows through this bimodal strip, it will then become heat up. Whenever it is heating up, this will try to move this side. Whenever it is moving, tries to this side, it will try to touch this. Let us see how it will move. For example, it is bent like this and it is trying to touch this like this. It is trying to touch this like this. Whenever it is touching like this, then what will happen? Where this arrangement is there, some mechanical arrangement, whenever, and here in this place it is bolted here. Also, screw was fitted here. Whenever it is touching this, then it will move like this. This will move like this. Then how it will be seen here? This will actually some spring arrangement is there, this spring arrangement is there. Actually, this will be bolted, this one. But now what is happening whenever it is moving like this? At this time, this is coming like this and this is also moving like this. So it was move like this. Whenever it is moving this left side, whenever it is moving left side, then what will happen automatically? This will also move set because of this tension of this spring. This will become like this. The region of the spring. So previously it was rotated by this, but now what happened? Because of this moving left side, this was moved up. Like this, this was open in the overflow condition. That's overflow condition. And second case is the short circuit condition. The short circuit condition, what will happen? Whenever the short circuit current flows in this, then what will happen? This solenoid will be magnetized fully as much as it is energized to pull this towards this side. Then that what will happen whenever it is moving this side? Obviously, it will move this side means it will become like this. Means this will try to move like this as it was happened in the previous case. At the time of the switch will be open. Like this, the MCB will be working. And by coming into the MCB, those two functionalities were same. Those two functionalities were same for the MCB and MCB. But only the difference is the current range. Only the difference is current range. And while coming into the ELCB, and while coming into the ELCB, what is ELCB? Ethyl leakage circuit breaker. Ethyl leakage circuit breaker for this. This circuit breaker, this ethyl leakage circuit breaker will use to protect from the ethyl leakage. It will protect the device from the ethyl leakage. If I am taking a three-phase supply, which is connected to the circuit breaker, I am taking one circuit breaker here, and the switch is like this. These are the contacts, and this was connected with three-phase load. We are connecting like this. Whenever the current flowing, whenever this switch was closed or the contacts was closed, then the current will flow into this. Then automatically the machine will run or the load will run. But whenever any winding was get damaged in this, or some insulation was lost for any winding, then what will happen? Some leakage current goes around this body. If everyone is touching this body of the leakage, then automatically it will get short. So, to avoid this, we will ground the body of the load. Then, before grounding this, we have to place ELCB between this. Why? Because if the leakage current is continuously going towards the ground, then what will happen? This machine will get heated up due to that more damage will be occurred. To avoid that, what we will do here in this we will place it ELCB. Internally it will be like this. Whenever the current which is flowing through this, means the leakage current which is flowing from device or the load to the ground, this will flow through the winding. Then what will happen? This will become magnetized. How will it be? How will it be operated? Let us see. actually this is circuit breaker, this is a tripping circuit, this is a tripping circuit. And let us, for example, if I am taking one switch here, I am connecting like this. For example, it is positive, it is negative. And one switch is like this, if I am placing, then what will happen? Whenever this is the load, whenever the leak is coming, which is flowing from load to the ground, which is flowing through the tripping circuit, means ELCB circuit. Whenever the current is flowing through this, this will be magnetized. Means across this, the potential difference will be placed. Due to that potential difference, it will be magnetized. Then that's why we are calling it as voltage operated ELCB. That's why we are calling it as voltage operated ELCB. Whenever it is magnetized, this will try to pull this switch down. Then what will happen? These two terminals will be closed. Whenever these two terminals are closed, then from the battery, what will happen? From the DC supply, the current will close like this. The current will close like this, and it will reach to the negative. And whenever the current is flowing like this, then what will happen? Obviously, this tripping coil. Whenever the current is flowing through this tripping coil, then what will happen? This will become magnetized. Whenever it is become magnetized, then this will try to attract this contact, moving contact. These are the fixed terminals, this is the moving contact. Moving contact. Whenever leakage current is flowing through this, then this will be magnetized, this will try to pull this switch down, and this fixed terminals will be closed, and the circuit will be closed. Whenever the circuit is closed, the current, DC current, which is flowing through this, and due to this, what will happen? This tripping coil will be magnetized, and this will try to pull this moving contact of the circuit breaker. Then the circuit breaker will be tripped, means the device was protected. So like this, in this we are able to see the MCB is the miniature circuit breaker. This will be operated from 60 to 80 amperes. High current performance or high current rating MCBs. These are all the MCBs, but high current rating, so that's why we are using here some different arrangement in the construction way, but basically same. So these will be used in 100 to 1600 amperes. And energy leakage circuit breakers. In the energy leakage circuit breakers, two things will be there. One is voltage operated one, and another one is current operated one. This RCCB is nothing but the current operated one. Current operated ELCB. This is also comes under ELCB only. That is residual current circuit breaker. Now, this ELCB, voltage operated one, we have discussed. Now we are going to, in the next class, we will discuss this RCCB, that is residual current circuit breaker. We will discuss this in the next class. But this is also very important, one voltage operated one. But in this, some drawbacks will be there. This will be operated with the voltage only. Whenever the volt potential difference in across this coil is there, if this that much of strength is there to attract this. So because of whenever high current flows, then only it will be operated. If very less currents are flowing, then it will, the potential difference in electrons will be very less. So that's why it cannot actually operate. Sometimes will not be protected. So that's why we will go for the RCCB. This will be discussed in the next class. Thank you.